Viagra. Doesn't help with me sex life, but it gives me just enough to stop me dribbling on me feet.
A lot of people have asked me, are you sick of people coming up and tapping you on the shoulder and saying, g'day, old fella? I love it. And if I wasn't doing that, I'd be doing nothing.
Flip her on her back and her legs fall apart.
Both my daughters are quite broad-minded and they are quite horrified by some of the content of Dad's jokes. And I love that because I was horrified at what was happening when they were 18 or 19. So I think that the old fella's got a bit of his own back.
Make a whole room smell like a pine forest when she farted.
I've had to realise that there are a lot of people out there that think I'm funny. Which I find quite ridiculous. You've got to remember, 2 years ago, I was driving a tractor around a paddock in ever-decreasing circles, and that was pretty exciting. And it imagines what this is like now. This is just, yeah, it's just quite mind-blowing.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am the old fella, and I wouldn't be dead for quids.
If he can nail this, the title and the cash could all be his. Put your hands together for the hilarious old fella.
Viagra. Hey, my old dad, he's still going. We give him a whole tablet every day. Doesn't help with his love life either, but it stops him rolling out of bed. Bingo. Mary loves to play bingo. You come to our place any Wednesday afternoon about 4:30, you'll see Mary there preening herself in front of our bedroom mirror, ready to go to bingo. You'll find me sitting on the end of the bed, drinking me second glass of something white, trying to get a bit of a shine up. Last Wednesday, Mary says to me, this is the ultimate question. This is the one question that'll make any married man's blood run cold. She says to me, does this dress make me ass look big? Now, I'm blaming the white. I'm still blaming the wine because I blurted out, looks like a two-burner barbecue. She said, what? I said, it looks too good to be true. Hey, we went out. We had a lovely night. She won some money at the bingo. We had a $5.80 roast at the hotel, bloody near won the meat tray. By God, we were close. We only missed out on one question. That question was, where do women mostly grow short, curly hair? Apparently, the answer's South Africa. We got that wrong. You got it wrong too, didn't you, Danny? Yeah. Yeah, we put down New Guinea. Anyway, we get to bed that night and I taps Mary on the bum. Now, for those of you that don't come from the country, out in the bush, that's called foreplay. I taps Mary on the bum and I says, hey, turtle. I says, we've had a wonderful night. You won some money at the bingo. I love that bit of pork at the pub. You know what? It'd cap this off. It'd be a bit of nookie. She said, I can't be bothered firing up a whole barbecue for half a sausage. Now, the last couple of shows I've put on here, these miserable buggers, all they've given me is a few old firecrackers. So let's see if they've come up with something good for the grand final. Ladies and gentlemen, I am the old fella and I wouldn't be dead for quids.
Well done, mate. Well, with the Australia Melbourne Youth Band, you finally got the climax. Finally got the climax you're after.
Thank you.
Well deserved. Good on you guys. Thanks for joining us. Kyle, let's go to you now. Thoughts?
Oh, I've seriously just stopped from a coughing fit. I'm not well. I've got the ear infections. I can't laugh or I cough. I've coughed and spluttered all the way through that. And I tell you, the reason that people do love you is because they do see a bit of their father, they do see a bit of their grandfather, and thank God there's someone else out there that can get away with some sort of non-G-rated jokes. I think you are a national treasure. I think that humour is true Australian, and I really hope that you get right up there and snatch that money, old fella, because that's probably the only thing you're going to snatch for the rest
thank
of your
you.
Life.
Impressive. Brian.
He's not well.
No, he's not well. The good thing is you have plenty of medication to help him out.
Oh, God. Again, old fella, it was just amazing to watch you. You're hilariously funny. It just takes that one word, Viagra, and that's it. I'm laughing before you even come out. They just said to me, who's next? I said, the old fella, and that's it. I just started laughing. But, you know, besides being funny and I'm really glad you're in the grand final, the one great thing is you're a great show to people that, you know, it doesn't matter what age you are, you can still start your dreams and start your career at any age, you know, and I'm really, really excited. And I hope there's people at home watching who have talent like you come forward now, because you're a great shining example that it's never too late just to start.
Thank you.
He targeted you in that performance there, Danny.
Oh, I'm definitely still laughing from that. What I love is that you come on this show and you're really humble about what you do. You're very, very good at what you do. People love the jokes, but people also love you. There's something that is so completely genuine and, you know, what can we say? We love your performance. People, you got to vote to get him through.
Thank you.
And the fact that you're still married after all the things that you've said about your wife is a miracle as well. You must have a fairly powerful relationship.
She's a very tolerant woman.
Well, the money is within grasp for all 10 acts tonight. Only you have the power to decide who gets it. For the old fella, just dial 1902 55 336 or SMS old fella to 1997772 until 12 noon Friday. I'll never look at turtles the same again after hearing the old fella. Well done. With another.